Greetings, dear friends, and welcome to the Blue Cube YouTube channel. In this video, I will teach you how to use the 3D rotation, 3D translation, zoom, eyedropper, and hand tools. If you look at the toolbar, you will notice that the 3D rotation and 3D translation tools are not there. To access these tools, click on the three dots here. Now you can see the 3D rotation and 3D translation tools here. To make it easier for us to access these tools, I will hold down the left click on this tool and place it here. This will place the 3D rotation and 3D translation tools next to the other tools. This way, we will have much easier access to these tools from now on. There are a number of other tools here that we will use and learn about in later tutorials when we need them. Okay, let's click here to close that window. Now, friends, to use the rotation tool, we first need to create a shape. So, I will create a rectangle. With the selection tool, I will select a part of this shape and change its color to make it distinct. Now, with the free transform tool, I will select my shape completely. If I want to work with the 3D rotation tool, I will select it, and if I hold down the left click and drag, you will notice that nothing changes. The reason why we cannot use the 3D rotation tool now is that we first need to convert the shape to a symbol. So, I will right-click on the shape and select the Convert to Symbol option to convert the shape to a symbol. Then this window will open for you. I will teach you this window in full detail later, but for now, just to teach you this 3D rotation tool, I will click OK with these settings. Now, when my shape is converted to a symbol, I will select the 3D rotation tool. You can see that lines have been created in the middle of the shape, and if you hold down the left click here and drag, you can create a 3D effect for the shape and rotate it on different axes like this. You can do this on both the X and Y axes as well as the Z axis. You can also hold down the left click on the red circle and rotate the shape freely on all axes. You can also change the rotation point by changing the location of the anchor point. Now I will press Ctrl plus Z several times to return the shape to its previous state and double-click on the anchor point again to center it. Now, this time I will select the 3D translation tool. Now you can see that two axes have been created on the shape, and I can move the shape along the Y axis like this. And I can also move the shape along the X axis. And since the shape is in 3D mode, you can see that the direction of the shape also changes with each movement. There is also an axis in the middle, which is the Z axis. If I place the mouse in the center of the shape, the letter Z will appear. Now, by holding down the left click and dragging, I can move the shape along the Z axis. For example, I will move the shape away and then I can bring it closer again. And here's how to work with the 3D rotation and 3D translation tools, which we will use a lot in future projects and can create different 3D shapes. Remember that in Adobe Animate, the X axis is red, the Y axis is green, and the Z axis is blue. Also, friends, in addition to the two tools that I just taught you, I want you to get acquainted with the eyedropper tool. The eyedropper tool samples the color of objects and transfers that color to other shapes. For example, I will create a rectangle and make it green. When the shape is selected, I select the eyedropper tool and click on the red color. This will change the color of the rectangle to red. Or if I choose the blue color, the rectangle will turn blue. So this was the use of the eyedropper tool, which I also introduced to you. The next tool is the zoom tool. I select it. If I want to zoom in on a shape, I just hold down the left click and create a box and then release the left click. This will zoom in. I can also come here again and select the fit in window option to see the entire document. Also, friends, by holding down Ctrl and the minus key that comes after the number 0 on the keyboard, you zoom out of the document. and if you press the Control and Equal keys on the keyboard, you zoom in on the document. Also, whatever tool you have selected, if you press the Z key, the zoom tool is activated. Then you can zoom in by clicking on the desired location. I select Fit in Window again. The next tool is the Hand tool, which I select. When I zoom in on the document a bit and hold down the left click, I can move around the document. You can also do this by holding down the space bar. I go back to Fit in Window again. The next tool I want to introduce to you is the Rotation tool. When you select it, you can rotate the document. Remember that this tool does not work in Fit in Window mode, so I change the zoom level. Now if I hold down the left click and drag, I can rotate the document like this. Wherever I click, the rotation will be created from there. I go back to the previous state again. We will cover the Time Scrub tool in future lessons, which is for testing and displaying animations. Right now, since we haven't created an animation yet, we can't use this tool. In the next lesson, when you learn how to animate, we will cover this tool. Okay, friends, these were all the tools that I wanted to tell you about in this tutorial. Be sure to practice all of these. Don't rush into creating animations because all of these tools that I am teaching you are very essential. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button or the subscribe below the video, and please like the video. Goodbye for now.